Yes, sir.
Yes, we see in the previous classes that how the Fourier series is defined and the conditions for the Fourier series. Also, we seen the example problems were particularly represented the given function as Fourier series in an interval of length 2 pi. That particularly in two categories of intervals will be considered from 0 to 2 pi as well as from minus pi to plus pi. In a general interval as from alpha to alpha plus 2 pi, right? Now, this is a given simple interval being considered of length 2 pi for periodic functions in general, right? Usually sine or cosine functions, right? They were having 2 pi period. So hence the intervals may be considered of length 2 pi, right? Hello.
Right. So yes, sir.
So now we extend our knowledge to any interval. It is not necessary that the function to be expanded only in the given interval of length 2 pi, or form either from 0 to 2 pi or minus pi to pi. They may be giving you in any general intervals also. It is needed to expand the given function as Fourier series in any given interval. In any given interval that may be of length, general length 2L. 2L. L may be any constant. So that in such case, we have to change the interval of length 2 pi to 2L. 2 pi to 2L. How we can change?
That L will lie from 0 to pi, or it can be any.
So here, now today we will look at the change of interval. Change of interval. So here we have the Fourier series for any function fx in an interval alpha to alpha plus 2 pi. Suppose in an interval alpha to alpha plus 2 pi, we know the Fourier series fx is equal to what? Everyone know that a naught by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx, right? This is the Fourier series where you know a naught, an and bn. That also I would like to write it here for your clear identification. 1 by pi integral alpha to alpha plus 2 pi into fx dx. An is equal to 1 by pi. Tell me.
What is
fx cos
nx? And bn is equal to 1 by pi
integral fx sin x.
Good. F of x sin nx dx. Right. This is we know as the Fourier series in the general interval alpha to alpha plus 2 pi. Suppose if you change this interval, I said, to any general, here also we can write it, that is from alpha to alpha plus 2L. Instead of 2 pi, we will take it 2L, any general length L, any general length L. So in such case, how can we put it? What will be the substitution? We can change this one. We can change this one. We can change by putting say z or y, y or z, we can put z is equal to pi x by l. Z is equal to small z, put this transformation, x is equal, z is equal to pi x by l, x varying from earlier alpha to alpha plus 2 pi. Now the z will be having in the new interval, that is alpha to alpha plus 2l, or we can write it here, x is equal to z l by pi, right? Z l by pi. What will be the dz? Cos x, where we can, where we have that dx is needed, right? So from that we can write it. So that implies dx is equal to l by pi dz. Here you can understand that l, any constant. Okay. So therefore we are considering 2l length. Of interval. Okay, so now put it this transformations, z is equal to pi x by l, or x is equal to z l by pi, dx is equal to l by pi into dz. Now when x is equal to alpha, right? When x is equal to alpha, what will be the z? Z is equal to
alpha by l,
right?
L.
Pi alpha by l.
L.
Okay? Because okay, pi l constants, alpha also constant. So therefore pi alpha by l is also a constant. That you may be take it as beta. Okay? That you may take it beta. Next, when x is equal to alpha plus 2l, then what is that?
Sir, beta pi plus 2l.
You can write it alpha pi by l into x. X means alpha plus 2l.
Plus 2l.
That you can write it as
beta plus 2l by l.
Alpha
2 pi, beta plus 2 pi,
sorry. P alpha by L plus 2 pi, right?
Yes.
This is equal right, to beta plus, beta plus 2 L, 2 pi only, right, beta plus 2 pi, right?
Yes, sir.
Thus, the function f of x of period 2L is transformed into the function. So what we can see from this transformation, that the function fx of period 2L in alpha comma alpha plus 2L is transformed to the function which will be f of x means z l by pi, right? This is say f of x. Okay, equal here brackets so that it will be considered f of z l by pi. This fx is transformed to f of z l by pi. This you may be consider fz, capital f of z, new function in which interval? Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This function is transformed to this like. So hence, the above Fourier series expansion, we will see fx become capital Fz. Can I write directly?
Sir, f z l by pi.
That is I just writing capital F z. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So hence, capital F z is equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nz, right?
Nz
cos nz plus bn sin nz, right? Where what is a naught? A naught is equal to 1 by pi integral beta to beta plus f of x is, what is x? Z l by pi, or that may be capital Z of f of z, you can write capital f of z dz, right? So or capital f of z also you can write here, okay?
Yes, sir.
In the same way, write it a n is equal to 1 by pi integral beta to beta plus 2 pi f of z l by pi into cos n z dz, and b n is equal to 1 by pi integral beta to beta plus 2 pi f of z l by pi sin n z dz. Okay, so these are the new transformations into the given function, which we have been, this interval is being transformed into any general interval, no? This general interval is transformed into,
excuse me, sir,
beta to beta plus 2 pi, beta to beta plus 2 pi, right?
Hello, sir. Sir, we have changed z is equal to pi x by l. So, sir, in the equation, cos n z will not be there. Z l by pi will be there, I think.
Yes. See, you have to write it now. X is equal to z l by pi.
And so dx equals to l by pi dz.
This will be f of z. We are substituting above z pi is equal to capital. It will come in you like
inside cos n z. Inside cos n, sir, in that cos n z we have to put cos n z l by pi.
Sir, in cos n z there will be, sir, l by
pi. Plus dl is transforming into beta comma beta plus 2 pi. This is the version. While this general interval is transforming, because we don't know for this general interval, for that general interval we are transforming into this interval beta comma beta plus 2 pi of length 2 pi with this substitution. Okay,
what about the dz?
You have used this one written dx ZL by pi. Listen here, using this transformation we transform this general interval into this interval, right? Hello. You understood, dear students?
Sir.
Hmm.
Sir, in the new A naught, it is written dz, but sir, there should not be dz into L by pi.
Where?
Sir, the A naught value, A naught value has dz.
A naught value?
Sir, A naught value is having a dz, but there should be, sir, L by pi dz, right?
L by pi?
Yes, sir. Where is that L by pi value?
You just substitute this one, this substitution in earlier, before this.
That is what, sir, I am saying. You have written there dx is equal to L by pi into dz. But, sir, here you have just written dx is equal to dz. Where is that L by pi term, sir?
That will be cancelled.
How, sir?
In dx is equal to L by pi into dz is there.
Right, sir. Right.
Wait. L by pi into dz. One minute. Yeah, okay. You see, here we have converted this interval into this form, right?
Right, sir.
Beta to beta plus 2 pi. Right?
Right.
In beta plus 2 pi in new interval, we are writing the Fourier series expansion for the respective function. That function will become f of z l by pi, right? Z l by pi, it will be f z we considered. If you take f z, its Fourier series expansion in this interval beta and beta plus 2 pi, what will be, right?
Okay.
So in such case, what will be giving you? Here just I written the normal f only, so there you maybe make it capital FZ without confusion. You write it a capital FZ, right? Later I will tell you that how it will be inversible. Don't think about the inversible sense. Here you see that. So for this is the Fourier series expansion for any function in this interval beta and beta plus 2 pi, right? Yeah. An is 1 by pi integral beta to beta plus 2 pi fz dz, fz into cos nz dz, bn is equal to this, right?
Right, sir.
Is it clear or not?
Sir, if this capital FZ, we change it to small fz, small f of zl by pi, then that dz will be changed.
Wait, in this interval, alpha to alpha plus 2l is transformed into beta to beta plus 2 pi with the transformation x is equal to z
l by
z l by pi, right? Fx will be transformed to fz. Okay.
Okay, sir.
We are not writing fx form. We are writing in fz. This function transformed to fz. Now we know the Fourier series. We know the Fourier series for fz in the interval, right? Beta to beta plus 2 pi of length 2 pi. That is what we have written here. Okay. A not
sir, small f z l by pi is equals to capital F z. Sir, how this transformation is done?
Yes, sir. How this can be written?
Which one?
Small f z l by pi is equal to capital F z.
This one?
Yes, sir.
But I don't know what you are asking.
Sir, you have assumed that small f z l by pi is equal to capital F of z, right?
Right.
Yes.
Yes. If you have assumed that, then sir, in that equation, a naught is equal to that something stuff. There we can replace f z with f z l by pi. And if that is possible, d z should be equal to d x into l by pi. But you have written just d z.
You are again A to B, B. You are again thinking from B to A. We transformed fx into fz. Fx function will come into fz, right?
Yes, sir.
So we are just thinking fz in the interval beta to beta plus 2 pi, that's all.
Okay.
What z will be, now we are coming into the reversal substitution. Now I am writing, now making the reverse substitution. Reverse substitution. So what will be that? Z to be put in X, right? Pi x by
L or C.
C L. Pi x by L. Right? Pi x by L. Now you see. Put z is equal to pi x by l here itself, you will get it. There also, you may be put dz is equal to what will be pi by l dx. Now you write it, what will be happen? That resultant values, function f of z become fx. A naught by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos z will be cos n n into z, that will be n pi x by l plus bn sin n pi x by l. right? Into dx. No, sorry, not dx. Right? Where what is a naught? You just substitute over there. A naught will be 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2, alpha to alpha plus 2L, that you make it. Alpha will be a constant. Okay? Making in this one, therefore that Fourier series expansion of fx in an interval which will be giving you alpha comma alpha plus 2L. Alpha plus 2L. So therefore 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2L fx into dx, which will be how it will be coming here. You people making you confusion, right?
Right, sir. We were confused there, but now
no
it's
problem.
Fine.
Now put it, z is equal to pi x by L, right? This z is equal to pi x by L. This conversion are why were you confusing in this? I will write it here. Exactly, I am substituting that beta alpha to alpha plus beta to beta plus pi, beta plus 2 pi will coming into like this form, right? It is okay. This is okay. How it will be transformed?
Okay, sir. Okay, it's
here in integration you will see that is 1 by pi integral alpha to alpha plus 2L, it will giving you capital F of z. Z means what? Pi x by L, right? Into dz. What is dz? Pi by L into dx. Okay?
Right.
So here it is x, here it is something. For that you may put pi x by L is equal to some u. If you want, this will whole will be giving you like this. Okay? This will be a function of x. This pi by L will go into that side. There it will be cancelled. Pi by L and pi L by pi. Here it will be coming u 1 by L. Or here this pi get cancelled. 1 by L will be there. This is not required at least. 1 by L. This will become fx. Okay. Function of x. Are you clear or not?
Clear, sir. Now it is clear.
Reversal, like, you know, happens.
Clear, sir. Clear.
Not confused. Yeah. And an is equal to 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2L fx into cos n pi x by L into dx. Bn is equal to 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2L fx into sin n pi x by L into dx. Okay? This is very important, where any function fx can be expanded in an interval alpha to alpha plus 2L of length 2L period, this fx will be this one. And the coefficients will be 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2L fx dx. So these we can write it. The interval that alpha to alpha plus 2L. Of length 2L also can take into two forms. One is 0 to 2L and another one is minus L to L. Right? Now in an interval 0 comma 2L and minus L comma L, these coefficients A0 is equal to 1 by L integral 0 to 2L, sorry, fx dx. An is equal to 1 by L integral 0 to 2L fx into cos n pi x by L dx. Okay. Bn is equal to 1 by L integral 0 to 2L fx into sin n pi x by L dx. Fx is equal to a0 by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by L plus bn sin n pi x by L. Whereas these coefficients will be varied based on that interval, where that interval 0 to 2L, these are the given coefficients values. And in another interval minus L to L of length 2L same, where a0 is defined by 1 by L into integral minus L to L fx dx. Similarly, an is equal to 1 by L integral minus L to L fx into cos n pi x by L dx. And bn is equal to 1 by L integral minus L to L fx into sin n pi x by L dx. Okay? This is important. This may be take it as some equation number. Yeah, here one. These are two. This is three. These are four. Okay? Where if an interval of length 2 pi, then the Fourier series of any function in that interval is given by fx is equal to a0 by 2, sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. The respective coefficients are there, n into x only, okay, cos nx, sin nx like. Whereas in an interval of length 2L, any general interval, alpha to alpha plus 2L, then the Fourier series of the function fx in that interval is a0 by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by L plus bn sin n pi x by L. So here the braces must be, because otherwise 2 times 2 we write the sigma. An cos n pi x by L plus bn sin n pi x by L. Right? Where a0 is equal to 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2L fx dx. An is equal to 1 by L integral alpha to alpha plus 2L fx into cos n pi x by L dx. Bn is equal to this much, right? Thus, that we can extract into the particular intervals of length same 2L in two intervals. Students, hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So here one must be understand. One is the Fourier series expansion in an interval of length 2 pi. One pattern of Fourier series and their coefficients. And then if the interval of length 2L and what is the Fourier series expansion, their respective coefficients. This is two must be understand. Okay. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now coming into the special cases are special cases of Fourier series. Special cases of Fourier series. I am going into the general interval only of length 2L from minus L to L for our convenient. So consider the special cases, no? So consider the Fourier series of fx in an interval from minus L to plus L plus L of function fx given by, tell me, anybody tell me what is fx is equal to? A0 by 2 sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity
an cos
an cos n pi x by l, right? Don't confuse, plus bn sin n pi x by l, right? Where a naught is equal to 1 by l integral minus L to L fx into dx. An is equal to 1 by L integral minus L to L fx cos n pi x by L into dx. Bn is equal to 1 by L integral minus L to L fx into sine n pi x by L into dx, right? Say equation 1 and this is 2, not required, so here we will be modified, no problem, 2. Now the special cases, number 1. If f of x is even function, right? If we consider f x is an even function, where f of x is defined in an interval from minus L to L or minus pi to pi, whatever it is. So consider if f x is an even function, f x is an even function. Right? Then obviously, what is A naught? What is A naught?
0 to L, 2 by L, fx, dx. 2 by L, fx,
dx. Right. 1 by 2L, integral 0 to L, fx, dx. And an is equal to 1 by 2L integral 0 to L fx into cos 1 by x dx, right?
2 by L. 2 by L.
But bn is equal to
2 by L.
2 by L.
2 by L.
by L.
And where?
Two by L. Right. Two by L. Right. Okay. Vn is equal to zero, right? Vn is equal to zero. Why? Fx is even function, sine function is odd. Even again odd. Odd function value integral from minus L to L becomes zero, right?
Right, sir, right.
Therefore, what is fx? A naught by 2. The Fourier series of the function.
Sigma 0 to, sorry, n is equal to 1 to infinity. Cos of, sorry, an into cos of nx. Just it, sir.
Nx, sir.
N pi x.
Nx. N pi x by L.
Sorry,
don't
sir.
Don't confuse, please. Okay, n pi x by L, right?
Plus.
No, sir. That's all.
Bn 0 for all n.
Oh, sir. Yes,
sir.
For all n, Bn is equal to 0. So therefore, for this special case. So what we observe from this here? So therefore, fx, the Fourier series expansion, is having the coefficients with only cosine functions, right?
Right, sir.
So hence, the series, the Fourier series expansion in 3 is called what? Can anybody say?
Fourier
Fourier cosine series. This is simply we call it as Fourier cosine series. Remember, because the Fourier series contains only cos terms.
Instant in
cosine terms. Right? It contains only cosine terms. So hence it is called Fourier cosine series. Fourier cosine series. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now yes, coming sir. Into the next case. If fx is an odd function.
A naught and an will be 0, sir.
Only minus L to L. Yeah. In such case, obviously, A naught 0 and also AN 0.
AN 0.
And BN. BN is equal to
2 by
2
L.
2 by L integral minus to L. L to L. F.
So 0 to L.
This is called cosine.
Yes. Fx sine n pi x by L into dx. So hence, the series, the Fourier series of fx is given by fx is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity, right? Bn sine n pi x by L, okay? Right? The above series. Contains only sine terms. So hence it is called 4 is called what?
Fourier sine series.
Fourier sine series. Very, very important. Fourier sine series. Likewise, we can define the Fourier cosine series, Fourier sine series. Right? Fourier cosine series, Fourier sine series. Okay? Now, coming into the half range series, half range series. Sometimes, where the function is required to approximate or represent the Fourier series expansion in a range or in an interval 0, L instead of 2L. Okay? Earlier we seen the function is defined in an interval minus L to L, that is of length 2L. R 2 pi, we have seen the Fourier series expansion and the corresponding coefficients. Suppose if we needed to represent or approximate the given function in an half interval, in such case, we do not know the function behavior in the outside of this interval, whether it may be an odd function or it may be an even function, right? So then how we can find the Fourier sine series or Fourier cosine series in the given half interval?
What if we write L as L by 2?
How?
Sir, the
if as you said, the interval is
what it will be happen. Sir, so here sir,
we extend the
very understood.
Like, negative side also.
Understand here, it is not the full interval, it is an half interval. We need to represent the given function fx represent into a Fourier series in 0, L, half interval. This is our aim.
Sir, my question
is our aim. Understand.
Sir.
Our aim is to expand the function fx as a Fourier series in an half interval. 0, L. It is not full interval. You may take L is equal to L by 2. Please understand. Don't make confusion. L is equal to L by 2. That is also not a full interval where we cannot define the function is either it is an even function or odd function. Our target is to find out the Fourier series in a half interval. That Fourier series in a half interval, it may be become either Fourier sine series or cosine series only. Right?
Okay, sir.
Fourier sine series, Fourier cosine series are the special cases of Fourier series. If you want to find out the Fourier sine series or Fourier cosine series in the half interval, so we have lack of the information. We don't know the function nature outside the interval. So therefore, it cannot be fully justified to taking the sine series or cosine series representation. Understand, it is not exact series expansion, it is an approximation. Please understand, it is not exact function. Right? One function we are approximating, one function we are representing in a series expansion. That series expansion, it is not 100% exact to the given function. Right? Hello.
Correct, sir.
Yes, sir.
So here,
finding
Fourier cosine series or Fourier sine series in the half interval, it is lack of information. We cannot exactly expand the function in the half interval. So that what we do is here, let us see. I will make it a graph. We have only 0 to L exact function. Say the function is like fx is equal to x in the interval 0 to L. Okay?
Okay.
0 to L only we have. But to find out the Fourier sine series, suppose if you want to find out the Fourier sine series of fx in an interval 0 comma L, how we can find out? Is it possible? Finding Fourier sine series in the half interval? When the Fourier sine series will be possible?
When the function will be odd.
Odd in an interval minus L to L.
Right, sir.
So now we extend our function as of our requirement to find out the Fourier sine series in the half interval. We extend our interval into minus L to 0. Minus L to 0. This is our assumed interval, extended interval beyond the given interval 0 to L. This is given. This is extended interval. In this extended interval, as of our requirement for Fourier sine series, we feel that extended function also to be what?
Sine.
Odd function, right?
Sine.
Tell me.
Sir, we have another class from 12.
You can leave. So I will upload this one into the your files. You can do it that Fourier half range sine series. It is called Fourier half range sine series. Fourier half range cosine series. Okay, good. You may be leave.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, students. Some of them are there.
Yes, sir.
You don't have the class?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
You people are belong to which group? D1 or D2? Mixing? Hello? Okay, let's see here. We extend the interval for finding the Fourier cosine series. The function will be considered as even function so that the Fourier cosine series will be given you like this. Fx is equal to a0 by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by l dx. a0 is given by 2 by l integral 0 to l fx dx. an is equal to 2 by l integral 0 to l fx into cos n pi x by l into dx, where here there is no dx in the series. Here dx will be right. Okay, this is called the Fourier half range cosine series. B is the Fourier half range cosine series. A, this one, where a naught an were given like this, where Fourier half range sine series. Okay, where we can see, so here nowhere that extended interval is being considered. For getting the Fourier sine series or Fourier cosine series in the half interval, we can extend our interval 0 to L into minus L to 0. So that the total extended interval become minus L to plus L. There we can define the function. Fx is considering even function or odd function as our desired approximation. Okay, sine series. So that here can be understood very clearly. The same function can be extended in a half interval in terms of either sine series or cosine series. Okay, so here it must be very clearly understood that the Fourier half range series can be achieved in different terms also. Sine series also or cosine series also we can easily to get it. So here we can I will mention you as a note so that you can clearly understood the same. For the same function we can express in different series, that is mainly. We can get different forms of series. Different forms of series for the same function. That may be a Fourier sine series or Fourier cosine series. You will get it. Here I am giving you the example. You can do it here. Express fx is equal to x as a half range sine series in the interval 0, 2. Okay. the Fourier half range series, sine series, you know that given by, you know, half range Fourier sine series is given by fx is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x by l. L is equal to 2. The interval is 0 to 2L. L is equal to 2. So therefore, you may be calculate 2 by L bn 0 to L fx into sine n pi x by l dx. You calculate this, it will giving you minus 4 into minus 1 whole power n by n pi. This is bn. So hence, the Fourier half range sine series is given by fx is equal to, you can substitute b1 sine pi x by l, b2 sine, and putting n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. It will giving you that 4 by pi sine pi x by 2 minus 1 by 2 sine 2 pi x by 2 plus 1 by 3 sine 3 pi x by 2 minus 1 by 4 sine 4 pi x by 2 plus so on. This is Fourier half range sine series for fx in the interval 0 comma l. In the same way, you can see it here, express fx is equal to x, okay, as a half range Fourier cosine series. Cosine series in the interval 0 comma 2. So here you can see, now what will be the Fourier half range cosine series? Fx is equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by l, right, where a naught is equal to 2 by l integral 0 to l fx into dx. An is equal to 2 by l integral 0 to l fx into cos n pi x by l into dx, okay, where given l is equal to 2 and a naught is equal to, you can calculate that value, a naught is 2 and an is equal to 4 by n square pi square into minus 1 whole power n minus 1, okay. So therefore, by substituting all of them, all the coefficients in the above series, we will get the required series. Is fx is equal to, just substitute, a naught is equal to 2, so therefore 1 minus 8 by pi square, you simplify that all, okay, 1 by 1 square into cos pi x by 2 minus, plus 1 by 3 square into cos 3 pi x by 2 plus cos 1 by 5 square into cos 5 pi x by 2, okay, plus so on. This is the Fourier half range cosine series. You can see What is fx? Fx is same from both the 1 and 2 equation, 1 and 2 problems, where in first problem, x is given in sine series. It is also the same expression, resultant series, where in the same interval, same function in same interval, which is being expanded in two different forms. One is in terms of cosine series, one is sine series. Okay, this is due to the half range. So we are interesting to expand the given function or representing the given function x into a Fourier series, cosine series or sine series. That is our desire in the same interval 0, 2 in two forms. This is what we can say. Both of them were same as of our desire. So we can extend our given function in the given interval as Fourier half range sine series or cosine series. There is no confusion. Both of them were right. Okay. Good. This is Fourier half range or sine series. Thank you. Any doubts, students?
No, sir.
Okay. You find out this? We will do the problems. Actually, these concepts are needed to solve the second unit that we will see in the next class. Right. The problem we can see in individually in the tutorial classes. The rest of the problems we can solve in the second unit that we will do. Right.